in the Asian organized crime. It's so easy to hide and to be uncatchable.
Heads of Asian gangs are traditionally not flashy like some of the mob bosses that we've come to know. They tend to fly under the radar in the shadows. And that made it so much harder for anti-organized crime squads to figure out who's the one running things.
At that point, we believed that Tze Chi Lop was running the organization in China. He could have been on Mars, as far as I was concerned, because we had no extradition treaty with China. We had no cooperation with the Chinese.
If Lop stay in China, forget it. When I learned there was a meeting planned in Hong Kong by Lop with major league people in the heroin trade, I called Cal Nan and tell him, you want me to catch him for you?
I thought, holy moly, this could actually work. We know that once we get to Hong Kong, we're not gonna call the shots. It's gonna be up to the Hong Kong PD.
So it was 6 o'clock or a little bit later, then Lop arrived. And got identified by the surveillance. We got him.
I really thought he didn't exist because I never saw anything tangible about Tze Chi Lop. I just heard words. And they told me that I could speak with Lop. The only time I felt he was real was when I sat across from him and I could look him in the eye. I was blown away by how normal he was, how he could blend into a crowd. There was nothing about him that shouted out, you know, international drug trafficker. He was just a regular guy. You know, he wasn't big or strong or dressed fancy clothes or any of that stuff. He was very, very Mr. Normal.